When I was 6 years old, my daddy took me to see a man being hanged, right where you're standing now. Half the city was here. Forty thousand people turned up to see Deacon Brodie swing from a gallows tree he'd designed himself. A proper 18th century gentleman. Or so everybody thought. But somehow, in a small city where houses crowded close, and people knew every noisy detail of their neighbours' lives, Brodie managed to keep his secrets. Not a single member of the Edinburgh establishment was aware that he had not one, but two mistresses, who between them had given birth to five of his children. It takes a lot of money to keep a secret as big as that. Brodie's answer was simple. He was the city locksmith. So he made extra copies of the keys that unlocked the doors of the rich and comfortable. And in the night, he crept into their homes and their offices and robbed the very citizens he rubbed shoulders with in business and politics. When they discovered how he'd bamboozled them, there was only ever going to be one outcome. I saw Deacon Brodie's last dance from my daddy's shoulders. Maybe you think that's a terrible thing to show a child, but that's Edinburgh for you. Don't be fooled by the superficial charms. Edinburgh is as ruthless as she is lovely. Here, now, at the turning of the year, when Janus-faced January looks to the past as well as the future, we're held fast in the frosty embrace of Edinburgh. Anything can happen in these pens and yards, these courts and lands, these venals and closes. These wines and brays. These markets and hay and grass and lawn and flesh. This is a city of opposites. Good and evil. Old and new. High life and low life. Respectable and very definitely unrespectable. But most of all, it's a city of stories.